We now invite our Director of Schools and Officiating Principal, Ms. Deepa Bhushan, to come on stage and address the gathering.
I think I'm going to stand here all evening waiting for the good evening. Thank you. I think you're waiting to see your children. Yes. Well, very nice to be here today. A warm welcome to all of you, and it gives me great pleasure to welcome Ms. Priya Dutt, our trustees, Mr. and Mrs. Goenka, our teams from the central office. We have Ms. Sheetal, our head of curriculum, Ms. Swati, our head of preschool. We have our two coordinators from our Thane school, Ms. Aarti, Ms. Shilpa, our teachers, and our team from Oshiwara school. So we have Ms. Neha, the coordinator, our teachers from there too, and our teachers from Lamington Road too. So we have this huge, huge, big family of, I'd say, people right now who are all working towards whatever is required for the children. So there's this interesting thing that every time, I'm meeting someone and, everyone will tell me, the children at CP Goenka, they are very confident. And I say, yeah, they are. They really stand out. Not like stand out, but stand out. And I said, yes, they do. The thing is that we've worked with our children for so many years that this just shines through, I think, naturally for them. And the children are confident, of course, because they have a voice. But one of the things that we're trying to teach our children is you have a voice, but it comes with responsibility, just as freedom comes with responsibility. So you have a voice, but to use it in the right manner, at the right time, in the right way, on the right platform, I think that's a must. And as school and as parents, I think we work jointly together in that direction. And that's something that we're going to continuously do and work with. I think in today's times, that's most important for children. While we're doing all these things with the children, so we really let them have their voice. And let me tell you, they have a voice. So today, I really have no speech to give or anything to say to any of you, but just to say that I'm a messenger today. Yeah? So before the show, I was talking to the children, and I was asking them, what should I go and tell your parents today? I don't know what to say, because everyone knows it all nowadays. You click a button, Google, you get everything. So I don't think I have any more gyan to give anybody. So I said, okay, what should I go and say to the children? So the children told me that I must tell you that they have said that you will need to clap very loudly. Can you do that?
Good. They can hear you outside.
They also told me, one of the girls told me, please tell my parents, and I think that parent would know, in the morning I felt I wouldn't be able to dance properly because I'm on the side. But, my parents said, go and rock it. And just tell them I'm going to rock it. So whoever's had this conversation, know your child is saying, we're going to rock it. The little ones told me that the show is amazing. We've really enjoyed it because they saw it during the trial run. So we are sure the parents are going to enjoy and very confident. Of course, they're going to clap for us. And they're going to clap very loudly. So some of the children told me, we want them to shout also for us. Do you know how to shout? Do you?
Yeah!
Yeah, that's nice. Okay. So that's one. So you know that, very good, that's a third whistle, super. So you've got your claps, you've got your shout, you've got your whistle. Catcalls? Woo! Good, good. So I think the children are going to be happy. How do you say once more?
Once more!
I think we'll need coffee.
Once more!
I think, we all know what appreciation and encouragement does for children. So not only after that act, I hope you're clapping throughout the act. You're enjoying the show. The kids have put in a lot of hard work. We've had a very short span of time. 13 days is not much, and of which also all Saturdays. Do I need to say something to the parents? Okay, I won't say today. I keep that to myself. But Since we had a very short time, the children have done an amazing job. Whatever happens on stage now, the stage is theirs. And I believe that they deserve all the encouragement that they can get. So I'm looking forward to that from all of you. Yes? Thank you so much. I take great pleasure now in inviting our chief guest, Ms. Priya Dutt. I would like to speak a little bit about her. Ms. Priya Dutt has donned several hats, that of a member of parliament, a trustee of the Nargis Dutt Foundation, a wife, a mother, a social activist, a friend, and a common citizen. Not at all common, I must tell you that. She's the daughter of the legendary Srimati Nargis and Sri Sunil Dutt, who have been great humanitarians. Her greatest influence in her life has been her father, Sri Sunil Dutt. Her turning point in life came in 1987, when she accompanied her father on a 78 days peace march from Mumbai to Amritsar, covering a distance of over 2,700 kilometers with a message, "Give peace a chance." It was a time when the country, especially Punjab, was under a cloud of violence and communal discord. This walkathon gave her unforgettable insights into the real India, which touched her heart deeply. In 1988, along with her father, she marched from Nagasaki to Hiroshima, Japan, for world peace and nuclear disarmament, spreading the philosophies of the great Mahatma of brotherhood, understanding, and nonviolence. She has been a member of parliament for two terms, which everyone knows, and during this time, she played a very important role in uplifting the needs of the poor, empowering women, and improving health for her constituency and beyond. After her father passed away in 2005, she not only continued the political legacy he left behind, but also spearheaded the Nargis Dutt Foundation. The foundation works in the areas of health and education and has grown by leaps and bounds, with having equipped 80 to 100 hospitals across rural India. With medical equipment, holding medical camps for the poor, cancer screening camps, and holistically developing rural schools with clean sanitation, clean drinking water, computer labs, playgrounds, e-learning, and extracurricular activities. That's a lot that's happening. I hope we get a chance to be a part of this with you. She is also the trustee of ADAPT, formerly Spastic Society, and works towards the rights of the differently abled. Her favorite quote is, "The world needs dreamers, and the world needs doers. But above all, the world needs dreamers who do." So true. She believes. She believes no child should lose a life or be unable to pursue an education due to lack of funds. She has been a voice for the voiceless and is passionate about making a difference. And we hope to join hands with you in the same place. I'd like to invite you now on stage, please. Ladies and gentlemen, a huge round of applause for Ms. Priya Dutt.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Ms. Deepa, for such a grand introduction, which I don't think I deserve, really. And Mr. and Mrs. Goenka, teachers, parents, and of course, dear children. I know all of you are patiently waiting for the show to begin, so I'm not going to bore you with long speeches or anything of that sort. I just want to thank especially Ms. Deepa, and as she's spoken a bit about the Nargis Dutt Foundation, I am very overwhelmed that we are going to be partnering with your children to really make a difference in society. And we are doing this with many schools so that we bring to the table what the kids need to understand and learn the most is value of life. And when we talk about gratitude, I think to be grateful for whatever you have, and also look at the have-nots and see how you can give back. So I think that is what we want to bring to the table to all the children, privileged children, going to such amazing schools in the city of Mumbai, and try to create a bridge between, you know, the children in the rural areas and the children in the cities, to create some sort of an understanding, to see what is lacking and how your children can really bring something to the table for them. And believe me, I think there was a wonderful interaction with the children of the school, and it was wonderful to see how compassionate they were. So I have to congratulate you, Ms. Deepa, and all the teachers to really instill that value in them, which is so, so important for the children today. And parents, I also want to appeal to all of you to really be encouraging to your children when they come to you for wanting to do something. And like I said, our interaction is, we're trying to get them to interact with children from village schools or children they might raise funds for their education. It will be a one-on-one connect. They will really understand those children. There will be an interaction between those children and them, and it will be a huge learning experience. Because after all, once the children get out of the life of school, which is so protected for them, they have to go out in the real world. They have to see what we kind of shield them from. And this is the first step to that exposure, that first step to understanding what life is all about. And so I won't take much of your time. I want to say, please enjoy the show. And I'm also a parent, and I know when I go for my children's annual day, we are all waiting to see them on stage and feel so proud and happy that our kids are actually turning out to be so confident, unlike most of us were on stage when we were children. So I think things have changed, education has changed, and it's wonderful to see these children blossom.
So thank you so much for having me here, and enjoy the evening. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ms. Priya Dutt, for your words of wisdom and inspiration. We would like to request Ms. Deepa to please escort our chief guest, Ms. Priya Dutt, and our trustees, Mr. and Mrs. Goenka, to the center stage to do the honors of picking up the lucky dip winners of the evening.
K22.
G2.
I think we can applaud the winners. It's okay to win.
U12.
No one's even running for that seat?
No.
Yeah, no? Okay, we'll keep it ourselves. Yeah, that's a good idea.
L10.
A19. Congratulations.
R10.
Oh, that's awesome.
I'd also like to welcome Ms. Manju, our principal of CP Goenka Oshiwara. I think she deserves a huge round of applause. She's here now with us. And Ms. Neha Pandit, senior coordinator at Oshiwara and the IBDP coordinator.
Congratulations to the lucky winners of the evening. I would like to take this opportunity to invite our respected trustee, Mr. Sandeep Goenka, to address the gathering.
Good evening, everybody. That sounds much better. I think when Deepa started off, it was like half the people were like awake and half. Okay. So I won't take much time. I know everybody is anxiously waiting for the show to begin. But what I would like to do right now is just would like to invite the heads of the schools here. It's a very important announcement I want them to make. And I think without them here on stage, it would be incomplete. And it won't be even right for me to do that. Sartai, Monica. Manju ma'am, please. Neha. Sheetal. Swati. They are a part of the huge team we have. We can't get the whole team, so they are representing each and every team member of the CPGS family.
All the other CP group coordinators and heads present, please join us. Please come on stage.
Admin, Usman sir, Sagar, you also please come in, yes.
The reason we are taking this extra 5 minutes is because the team who actually works behind the scenes and deserves all the applause needs to be here on stage for you to see. It can't be us because we are only sitting behind the desk. They are the ones who actually work relentlessly towards the betterment of the students and the organization to put us where we are. So Deepa, I'd like you to lead and make the announcement to the parents.
Well, I hope you all have seen the newspaper in the morning today.
Yeah.
Yes. So CP Goenka Juhu again in the top 10. We moved to rank higher, so we are on number 9. Let me tell you, not at all easy. When they came in for their survey and everything, we were all so nervous and you know, what's going to happen. But we're very happy. I'd like to take this opportunity to really appreciate the hard work put in by the school team. They have worked fabulously in this space. I want to really thank Sandeep sir and Archana ma'am for the kind of support that they give us. They've always told us one thing, and that is that whatever's right for the children, just do it, don't think twice. And I think that means a lot. Thank you to all of you for supporting and believing in us. And thank you so much for that. And of course, thanking our students more than anything. They're exceptional, and so we are. Otherwise, we wouldn't be. So I think a good round of applause for our children. As a family, it's not only CP Goenka Juhu, but our new babies within our family, which is CP Goenka Oshiwara and Thane 2, are among the emerging international schools of Mumbai and even Borivali. So I think they all deserve a huge round of applause. So we have the Oshiwara team and the Thane team here too. So a lot of hard work being put in by each and every team to ensure that the best is there for the children. So thank you so much, and thank you for reposing your faith in us always. Thank you so much.
Last but not the least, we moved one rank higher. We need to work harder to move in the first 3 top positions. That's where our goal is, and that's where we will be in the next few years with the support of all the parents and the students. And of course, my team, thank you. Very proud of you. Thank you, all of you all.
I think people have forgotten to mention our other 2 schools. I don't know how many of you all know, we have 2 more schools by the name Swami Vivekananda International School. One is at Borivali and one is at Kandivali.
They are huge schools, totaling about 13,000 students, and they have been ranked as number 10 and number 9 across all SSC board schools. So, yeah, okay, and very prominent and renowned alumni from those two schools. People who are not interested in cricket and who are interested in cricket, of course. Rohit Sharma is a part of our, he passed out from our school there. There's been great scientists, Dr. Chaitanya Giri, who's presently in NASA, and he was in the Rosetta mission in Germany, representing India. So these are two, three strong and very powerful alumni from those two schools. Thank you, and now I don't think we should take more time, otherwise we get pushed off the stage. So enjoy the rest of the evening. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sandeep sir and Archana ma'am, and thank you very much to all of you.
Thank you very much for your speech. You know, Arav, my parents always complain that I make them dance to my tunes. Now that's an art I learnt on my own.
The sound of bells, the steps from the beats, in the distant dreams. The real art is learning and performing one of our oldest classical dance forms, Kathak, an ancient form of telling epic stories and mythology through the movement of feet, hands and eyes.
But I have a twist for you, Arav.
Really, Adhan? Please tell us something about the twist.
Well, we have a fusion with a reggae pop song that topped the charts of 40 countries, becoming the first Spanish song since Macarena in 1996 to top the Billboard Hot 100. I'm sure you all must know the song Macarena, right? It's a song from your time. It was played 4.6 billion times across all streaming services.
So get ready for the enchanting dancers bringing you breathtaking performance of fusion shown through graceful movement and poise. Please welcome our very own Kathak dancers.